A legend says Lady Feng found a large hollow tree trunk floating on the river Mekong. In the hollow tree trunk, she found four bronze statues of Buddha. She constructed a temple on a small hillock. A city grew around the temple and is called Nand Fen, the hill of Lady Fen. Behind the Vat Nam, there is a benevolent statue of Lady Feng in a shrine of its own. Today's Phnom Penh, the capital of Cambodia, bears the signs of about 100 years of its French occupation. In 1953, Cambodia gained freedom. The Cambodian politics underwent patriotic twists and turns, but with the constitutional monarchy, the King of Cambodia had always a role to play. The royal tombs, the palaces, the royal temples are witness of it. in the heart of the city, there is a reminder of the brutal genocidal regime of communist Khmer Rouge headed by Pol Pot, the two slain genocidal museum. The museum is located in a former high school used as a detention prison. The Choeung Ek high school was converted to a prison when all the schools in Cambodia were closed by a government decree. The prison was run by Khang Klek Lu, also known as Comrade Dutch. With the stated aim of creating a purely agrarian-based communist society, the brutal paranoidal regime destroyed all the fabrics of social structure. From 1975 till the fall of Khmer Rouge and Pol Pot in 1979, 17,000 citizens passed through the gates of this prison to torture chambers, confession centers, and eventually to their deaths. The regime has left enough proofs of its acts in the form of meticulously maintained official records. From this prison, the prisoners invariably landed at determination sites, the killing fields. A memorial to the victims is constructed on the site. Some 20,000 mass burial sites are found in Cambodia. Between 1975 and 79, up to 3 million people lost their life due to the policies of Pol Pot government, starvation and disease. 21% of the population lost life. While returning from the chilling visit to the killing fields, our guide Kim said the memorial only tells half the story. On further probing, he elaborated on what happened when in 1979 Vietnam so-called liberated Cambodia from the Pol Pot regime.
The monastery place, they turned to the security and the killing field. So I heard the loudspeaker, they played the music to keep the sound, the sounding when they executing people. Yes. The fall of the Khmer Rouge, I sent my water buffalo to the somewhere near to the monastery place because there were a lot of grass that my water buffalo could eat the grass around there. And I visit to the pagoda, so I saw the skull of the dead people, deadly people. Yeah, a lot like this, like this.
They
so I recognize, oh, that is the place they killed. Yeah. Not survive, you know. Even after the fall of Khmer Rouge region, between 1980 to 1989, in where I live, the soldier of Vietnam in the regional, in the village, because the Vietnam troops, they come to base their military everywhere in Cambodia to again to the Khmer Rouge. Yes. So at night, Khmer Rouge, they come from the jungle, from the rural, into the town. Because in the town, the Vietnam base their military camp. So they're fighting. Like always start late night from 1 or 2. They did like fighting for 1 hour or 2 hours. And then they stop and run away. And who got destroyed? Village of people. And lives of the village people. Because they shoot in the village. The Vietnam, they always relocate their camp in the village of people live. They use people to protect their military corps. You see, this is the way they kill my own people. So they always say about 1975 to 1979, but why they don't say 1979 to 1978? How about Vietnamese for here? What did they do? And what about before that? This is a long connection, you know? Sad to see, painful.
The Human Rights Watch describes the present-day Cambodian government as vaguely communist, free market state with relatively authoritarian coalition ruling over a superficial democracy.